what love has in store. Living life and dreaming of true love's magical door. What kind of fantasy floats your boat? Darling, I'll take you to paradise now. Cast your vote. I've lived dangerously with the down and dirty pleasers, standing strong against those playgirl teasers, taking my time learning what love has in store, living life and dreaming of true love's magical door. I took the trip hoping to get your heart set. Love was the magic I could never forget. A woman's charm you can never resist. Love is the cure, so make it exist. Give it to me straight. True love's magical door holds the fate. Taking my time, learning what love has in store. Living life and dreaming of true love's magical door. That's for all the beautiful women out there. And my next song that I want to sing to y'all is a Christian song, and I devote it to all of the human race, because we all need to come together as a family, one family under God, and have heaven here on earth, my friends. Heaven on earth. And it will just bring you to the life that you deserve, because all about it is love, my friend. And this is called Heaven's Wings. So we're gonna come down on heaven's wings and carry you to the promised land, my friend. You were a locomotive waiting on the tracks. The comlink brought the message in waves. Did you get my facts? The lost world is certain. No quest beyond the fiery curtain. The atheist is divided between heaven and earth, and the only exit is the wall of fire. This barrier broke the key of desire. The lost world is certain. No quest beyond the fiery curtain. Wow, I'm amazed. I can't feel the flame. You put your family and friends to blame. Walk with Jesus and know his name. Forgiveness has no shame. The lost world is certain. No quest beyond the fiery curtain.
Huh.
We are worlds apart, yet we question what true life brings. Receive Christ and watch pure hearts sing. The chance to escape is on heaven's wings. The lost world is certain. No quest beyond the fiery curtain. Daniel Songer, thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, comedian, entertainer, Daniel Songer.
I wonder why Daniel lost his cameraman.
Hey, I'm back. Daniel Songer. The reason why I'm back is this is, what would you say, the grand finale? This is like the encore. So as long as I get the fans saying you want me, I'm going to stay here on this stage and perform the best that I can for you. DanPoetMan.com. I ask you as my fans, this is a way that you can keep me going financially, is please purchase my books. I'm a Statue, Heaven's Headline News, and Jesus's Poetic Song. You can purchase these books from my publisher at authorhouse.com. If you go danpoetman.com, there's a link right there to Author House. Please purchase all three of my books, and with these royalties, I can keep my house, I can keep this stage, and I can keep performing for my fans and keeping your life filled with joy. And that is what I want to do. So please help me, my friends. I come to you with all my heart. And here is my comedy act for you, my fans. Hey, you know what? What has been created throughout the world are names that give absolute pain. I'm talking about names that give absolute pain. And I'm like, no, I'm not talking about your ex-wife or your ex-husband or your ex-boyfriend, your ex-girlfriend. You know, I know that's a lot of pain, those names. But no, I'm talking about names like Harry. Oh my God, is he Harry, you know?
Yeah, it's he like, had a camera. I think he had two cameramen.
It's like, he is way too hairy. And you know what's even scarier than that is, oh my God, is she hairy? You know, it's like, oh my God, you know? I mean, I don't know. He is on the mat. He's on the mat. Oh, I don't want to look. It's too painful. He's on the mat. And you guys remember Charlie Horse? You remember Charlie Horse? You know, it's like your leg starts hurting. Charlie, Charlie. It's like, oh no, it's Dick. He's coming to get me again. It's Dick. Oh no, you know. Hey, you know, when you're in bed with your girlfriend, you're in bed with your wife, and
how would you know
she's
that, Dan?
Like, you know, oh, looking good, and you're like rolling over, and she's thinking, oh no, it's Dick. He's coming to get me again. And she's like giving you that, I'm tired, honey, I'm tired. Well, you know what? I've made up a name for the men of this world so that when it happens again, you know, when she's like feeling the need for speed, you know, she's feeling that need. And you're like, hey, honey, I'm sorry, you know, I'm so sorry, honey. I have got the Ben Peter. I'm sorry, Ben Peter. I've got the Ben Peter, you know. And she rolls over and grabs it, and she's like, stand, Peter. Stand, Peter. Oh, painful, man. It's like, honey, I've got the Ben Peter. And she's like, no, you don't. Stand, Peter. Stand. You know? But hey, man, you know what? What really gets me under lots and lots of stress, you know, and I have been under incredible amounts of stress today. Guys, I have run a company for my own for 20 years that has just fallen, down to lower than the sewers, buddy. And so that's why I'm out here saying, hey, I want to create a new business for myself and be a performer for you. So I ask for financial strength by purchasing my books, and that will help me to sustain my life and the Dan Poet Man show. And so what I want to tell you guys is stress, stress, stress. And you know what? You're going to get stress from your friends. And please open your heart and listen to the stress of your friends, because they're your friends. But what really gets me is when your friends start piling their stress and then their friends' stress onto you. I mean, people you don't even know, they're putting all this stress. And my buddy, he starts telling about this girl he's known his whole life. And the poor girl was molested as a child, raped through her whole life. And he starts telling me that he ran into her just recently and how she's like been a successful businesswoman. And I interrupt him. I interrupt the man. And I'm like, yeah, she's a successful businesswoman as a hit woman. She's a hit woman, man. She's in business for herself. No more Mr. Nice Girl, you know? She's like in business for herself. She's got the shotgun no more, Mr. Nice Girl. She's a hit woman. Hit woman. Hit woman. And my buddy's
that
like...
That story took such a hard left.
I'm like, man, no wonder this world breeds them, man. Breeding these people to becoming hit woman. USA. You know? I mean, she's probably global. Crazy, crazy, crazy. Hey, you know what? I am sitting there watching TV, guys. I'm surfing the TV, surfing. It's just like, you know how it is. You've been on there, you know, you couch potatoes, you're just sitting there surfing the TV. And you know, I mean, there ain't nothing on. So finally I hit this show. It's a talk show. And it's a bunch of women discussing who men, you know, I mean, what do these women do all day? They sit there talking about men, you know, what's up with the men, you know? And they're talking about how they believe that men think or believe that their soulmates are dogs. And I'm like, whoa, girls. I mean, I need to get on the phone and call into this talk show and set these women straight, you know? And boy, oh, I'm telling you, man, I call up, and of course, you know what I'm going to do is, you know, hey, you know, these women think that men believe that soulmates are dogs, you know? And I'm like, no. This sounds like it's a soul bait to the ugly duckling. And man, it's pretty clear that you could not handle your mistake, your soul mistake. They were the soul mistake. And then, you know what? They're trying to graduate from the ugly duckling so they'll get the soul date to the dog. That we're gonna get a soul date.
What a charmer.
To the dog, you know. And I wanna tell you, ladies, our soul fate is the goddess of love. The goddess of love. The goddess of love. Yeah. So we're looking for our soulmate. And we have got the soul fate. We've gonna make it happen. So come on, girls. Don't give us the soul bait. Cause we're through with your doggies. Roof, roof, roof. We're gonna
okay.
give it
What's
back
wrong with
turn.
Him? Like, I know there's
we
always been something wrong with him, but...
We got the soulmate impaction. Come on, girls. Soulmate.
This is really bizarre.
Soul date. Soul fate. Thank you. Daniel Songer.
Soul fate, stay night. What? No. We went through that.
Ladies and gentlemen, comedian, entertainer, Daniel Songer.
I don't know why this isn't playing them in order anymore.
Ladies and gentlemen, comedian, entertainer, Daniel Songer.
Hey, Daniel Songer, comedian, entertainer, here to give you some comedy, give you some entertainment, but most of all, to give you joy. DanPoetMan.com. is my homepage. Links there to, of course, YouTube, where you can see your buddy live. And also, there's a link there to my publisher of all three books. Guys, I spent 20 years of my life devoting writings to the world to develop joy. That's what I give to y'all, and this joy leads to love. So go to danpoetman.com and link to authorhouse.com, and again, buy all three of my books, and this will be my financial support from the world to keep this show going. Thank you so much. Guys, take a look at me, Daniel Songer. Go back to Comedy Act 1 and then go increment all the way up to Comedy Act 95 where we are today. And just take a look at me, man. Am I looking good? I'm looking good, feeling good, you know. And I mean, I'm out here in the South and I'm telling you guys, the women out here are not aggressive at all. They are not aggressive at all. It's like, what do I got tattooed on my forehead, man? It's yield. Yield is on my forehead. They're like, no, stay away. Stop. Stop this feeling. Stop this feeling. You know, I mean, come on, girls. I don't know what it is, but they are not aggressive. And who is? It's the young girls are aggressive, and it's like, jailbait, jailbait, you know, young girl, get out of my life. Your love for me is way out of line. You better run, girl. You're much too young, girl. You know, young girl, go home and study, because the big girl wants to come home and be my sex buddy. She wants to be my sex buddy. Love buddy is a place where we want to go. Love baby, baby, love baby, baby. Love is the place where we want to go. Love baby, sex buddy. Sex buddy, come on, you know, sex buddy is a place where we can get together. Love baby, love buddy, love buddy, sex buddy. Yeah, hey, oh, I wrote a poem for these girls out here in the South who are, like I said, they are not aggressive. You know, I get plenty of smiles, believe me. Well, lots and lots of women out there smiling away at your buddy, smiling away. So I wrote a poem here and I want to share it with you. It's called Take That Date. So I tell you ladies out there, if you see a man and you're attracted to him, get out there and be aggressive and take that date, you know? I mean, you only see on TV, you know, how women will ask a man out for dinner. Real life, it just don't happen, you know? It's like they always want to be in charge and that man to be asking. Well, this man is gonna make his stand. You remember? Come on, stand, Peter! Stand, Peter! You know what I'm talking about. It's called Take That Date. I saw her sitting across from me. As I gazed up to her, I asked her out for a date. Told her before it's too late. Take me, honey, because some guys won't
really
wait.
Small. People won't notice.
You know what kind of man you need. So come on, baby, take a chance with me. Take me, honey, because some guys go out for dates and some stay home and meditate. Take me, honey, before it's too late. Now get out of that temptation and make the sensation with me. Take me, honey, because some guys look for a date, but they never relate. Honey, I'll be sensuous and always adventurous for you. Take me, honey, take that date before it's too late. Because some guys play around and give you the bait. And some guys never get that date. Wherever we may be seen, you'll always be my queen. So come on, baby, take that date. I'll show you love and affection.
This is getting harder and harder to withstand.
Look in your direction. ocean.
I don't know why these
I
are all songs.
I saw her sitting across from me, so I asked her out for a date. Now she's mine because she's so fine. Forever we will date. We've got the fate because she took the date. You got it, girls? Get out there and take the date. Take the date. Be my soul. Be my mate. Be my love. And take the date. Daniel Songer, thank you.
So now I gotta do 96, which isn't up here. Here.
Ladies and gentlemen, comedian, entertainer,
we're so close to 100, though.
Daniel Songer.
Hello, Daniel Songer. I am now up to Comedy Act, Entertainment Act 96. So my fans were out there, they were saying, Dan, please stay to 100. Well, my friends, I'm way over 100 uploads, but I will try to perform comedy for 100 parts for my fans all over the world. And we'll just have to see what happens, my friends, after that. And even 97, I don't even know what's going to happen in 97, 98, 99, until the big 100. You know, maybe that will be this year. Hey guys, I want to introduce you to my books. I have been reciting poetry and singing my songs out of the books that I've written over the last 20 years. I've devoted my life, 20 years of my life, I've devoted to these books right here, my friends. These books right here are available right here. They're available at danpoetman.com. Links. They will link you to authorhouse.com, which is my publisher. And my first book, that's all the way to your right, I'm a Statue. And my second book, first of all, that took me 10 years to write. My second book, Heaven's Headline News. And my third book, Jesus' Poetic Song. Like I said, almost 20 years of my life devoted to all writing to give you joy, my friends. So what I want to do is I want to start out today with you from a song that I wrote. It's called Born Rich. And I wrote this back in the year 2000. You remember when that was the millennium and everything just seemed to change overnight? Well, here it goes. I was born in the back seat of a Cadillac. They say I was born rich. I woke up yesterday and found I was was a traveling man sitting in a ditch. Like my father before me, I was looking for a dream that took me in every direction. When will I find that great road that will be my connection? My throne will always be in my Cadillac. I'm the king of my castle, and my pursuit of a dream will keep me ahead of the pack. My father brought me into this world to carry on a dream and his great ambition.
Apologies.
My Cadillac implements me to be the traveling man and enables me to hold my family tradition. As I make my way throughout my travels, people remember me as the dream chaser. I will always desire the most beautiful woman, and I look for the day to face her. I keep wondering where this road is going to take me, but somehow I know I have the niche. This life I live has many obstacles, but my goals keep me moving to the day that I can bring into this world a son that will be born rich. That's right, I was born rich. Born in the back seat of a Cadillac. Born in the back seat of a Cadillac.
What?
Yeah, my friends, I'm a statue. Many, many more poetry in here. Many, many more songs, my friends, for you. If you remember my book, Heaven's Headline News, where yesterday I did a poem for you that was out of a chapter in here called Poem for the Day, and it was Monday. Today is Tuesday, so I'm going to do a poem I wrote here. Poem for the Day, Tuesday, my friends, Tuesday. And no, it's not Tuesday.
Hey, Giga Shame.
In the afternoon. Yes, it is. It is Tuesday. And here it goes. There are many languages in this world, but there is one language we all can comprehend, and that is the language of love. You were born into this world to carry on a family tradition, and through your baptismal and rejection of sin, your spirit and soul will be accepted into heaven above. With all the languages in this world, the most important words are please, thank you, hello, goodbye, and God bless you. I look to travel throughout this world to create happiness in your hearts, and I pray that all of God's children's hopes and dreams come true.
That's all I'm going to say
our
now.
Our trust starts with our mother and our father and excels into faith each and every moment of our days. We search throughout eternity for our soulmate and our Lord we eternally praise. My friends, poem for the day. Right here, guys. Heaven's Headline News. And my third book, right. Jesus' Poetic Song, that I want to do another poem, but it's a song that I wrote, so I hope y'all don't mind. I'm going to sing to you again. It's called One
Oh
with
My God. What's with all the songs?
I laid it on the line. They're distant to the word.
His
come
poor
on,
neighbors.
Come on, travel back to the calling of the bird. Are you going to be obedient to the smiling eyes? Knowing the electric candlelight, I sprung to the rise. You were told I would come out preaching. We both needed the teaching. Knowing the future keeps us reaching for the call. Sailing on, moving on. Take me to the final draw. I laid it on the line. They're distant to the word. Come on, come on. Travel back to the calling of the bird. Enduring as the fantastic dream. Anxious as the morning dove. You finally found the power of love. The answer came on shining wings to set us free. One world, one identity,
like, this
one
is the worst
with
we've watched.
God, we will
I can tolerate
always
all those
be.
Terrible jokes.
I laid it on the line. Now live for the word. Come on, come on. Travel back to the calling of the word. Come on, come on. Travel back to the calling of the bird. Come on, come on. Travel back to the calling of the word.
I need that opaque back.
Daniel Songer. Thank you.
All right, 97.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Please don't sing.
Entertainer Daniel Songer.
Hey, Daniel Songer, comedian, entertainer. I am here to perform a song for
no!
you written in the Wizard of Oz Somewhere Over the Rainbow.
Oh, God, he's going to butcher a classic.
Favorite song. It is sang so beautiful. So,
and I'm going to destroy
it. Bear with me here. I'm going to try to bring some joy to you with this song.
Huh.
Somewhere over the rainbow, way up high, and the dreams that you dreamed of once in a lullaby.
Made this bed and I'm gonna sleep in it.
Clouds are far behind me, where troubles melt like lemon drops away above the chimney tops. That's where you'll find me, somewhere.
Like when he turns the page.
Over the rainbow, bluebirds fly, and the dreams that you dare to.
Where's Elaine?
And clouds of white, and the brightness of day.
Have you been to the last few streams? Art streams?
I like the dark, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty.
Okay.
In the sky.
I didn't come across this video.
Are all so
I've known about this for I've known about this guy for years, but he has a few hundred of these,
of
and we're up to. I've been doing the videos in order for the last several days, and we're up to video 97.
I see friends shaking hands, saying.
But to answer your question, I came across it back in 2010.
Do you do? They're really saying, I love you.
Yeah. A few hundred.
I hear babies cry. I watch them grow.
Shit.
They'll learn much more than really know. And I think to myself, what a wonderful
hope it gets better. We're hitting a low point here with these.
Behind me.
He's mostly done comedy acts. Like, but these last, like, five, all he's done is sing.
Drops away above the chimney tops. That's where you'll find me. Daniel Songer, danpoetman.com.
Hey.
Thank you.
Ugh, I know. Well, here comes video 98. Please, please don't sing.
Ladies and gentlemen, comedian, entertainer, Daniel Songer.
Hello, Daniel Songer, comedian, entertainer, here again to give you joy for this entire planet, my friends. Planet Earth is my focus of giving joy, and that will lead to love and peace also. And remember, mercy comes from Jesus Christ. And my friends, I want to introduce you to my books again, and I have been doing poetry readings out of my books. I have been singing the songs that I've written. Over 12 albums I've written that are in these books, my friends. And anybody out there that's musically inclined, put the music with the lyrics that I sing and have fun. Go out there and just have fun. You know what I mean? So my first book, again, guys, I have spent 10 years writing this book all together with all three of my books. We've got I'm a Statue Here, my friends, first book. Second book, Heaven's Headline News. And third book,
we can't even
Jesus'
see him.
Poetic Song. All three of these books, almost 20 years of my life devoted to writing poetry, writing stories, wrote a couple of movies. But all these writings are all developed to give joy to the human race.
I say, really.
And now here I am on stage performing them live for my audience. I'm a statue, my friends. What I want to do out of this poem here, this book of poems, is a poem that I wrote back in 1993 titled The Need. And if you guys remember that one that I wrote, The Need for Speed, you remember? And that was a movie too, but this is called The Need. I have walked these streets for so long, losing my mind, never to find where I belong. People talking to the air, mindless philosophers, I'll be aware. I've got to find my way, I've got to hold on, I pray. I feel the need to succeed. I feel the need to succeed. I've got a future, I'm setting a goal. I receive this feeling through my soul. No more streets to fall down on. No more endless nightmares. I'm going to make it, I know someone cares. I've got to jump, I want to run. I love this life, how it is so much fun. I feel the need to succeed. I feel the need to succeed. I held on to a thought, looked for my future, that's what I've sought. Holding on to all my dreams, I'm taking life to all extremes. Do you want to know a secret? do you want to know a dream? Seek the success, and you will glean. I feel the need to succeed. I feel the need to succeed. My friends, I'm a statue. Heaven's Headline News, if you guys remember, now I have been writing a poem for the day that is in my book here. I wrote one for every day of the week, and as you know, I performed it for Monday, Tuesday, and now today is Wednesday. Poem for the day, Wednesday, my friends. The past is gone, and days dissipate very quickly, and now here it is, the middle of the week. I look forward to coming to your town to do a book signing and hear you speak. The words you recite will be heard throughout eternity and will be permanent in my mind. I ask you if you could make an analogy of one of my literary achievements and to all of God's children to be merciful and kind. Tomorrow is just another day in paradise and one step closer to your ultimate goal. Being an angel has always been your dream, and in heaven is where I will find your spirit and your soul. Friends for eternity, guys. That's what I believe in you. My third book, Jesus's Poetic Song, my friends. And this is a song that kind of goes with the rainbow, and this is called The Return of the Rainbow. The Return of the Rainbow. And I'm going to sing it to you guys. Your love is like a rainbow shining from the horizon to the point of no return. My love is like a rainbow shining from heaven to earth. It completes the circle of love.
Oh,
feeling your love, touching your love brings such a sweet emotion. Holding on to this feeling brings perpetual motion. My heart was created in heaven, and with my birth, my love became earthbound. Now I'm compelled to learn the ways of this land, but my heart treasured love, and I was born to love you. This body was born to take you away. This heart was given to show you the way. I've got the gift of generosity flowing through my veins. I'm a giver of love, and my heart takes root in your passion. Now our rainbow stretches from heart to heart. Feeling your love, touching your love brings such a sweet emotion. Holding on to this feeling brings perpetual motion. We're on life's journey, and soon we'll be sailing heaven bound. We connected the rainbow and the spectrum of love. Now our love is like a shining rainbow from heaven to earth. Now our love is like a rainbow shining from heaven to earth. This body was born to take you away. This heart was given to show you the way. Daniel Songer. No. Thank you.
Shit. I wanted to cut him off.
Ladies and gentlemen, comedian, entertainer, Daniel Songer.
Hey, comedian, entertainer, Daniel Songer. Hey guys, danpoetman.com will take you right to my homepage. And then there's a link there to my publisher, authorhouse.com. And from there, you can purchase all three of my books. I'm a Statue, Heaven's Headline News, and Jesus's Poetic Song. And I ask you, please go there and buy these books. And this will help me to have financial strength to keep my show going, Dan Poet Man Show. Besides the fact, keep me and sustain my life. So I ask y'all, please help me with this, and this will show your support to the Dan Poet Man Show by purchasing all three of my books. And so, hey, guess what, guys? You know how I love to dance. Well, I was out last night creating new dances, you know. Hey, man, it's a new dance. You know, it's Dan, he's the new man. Dan, the dancing man. Yeah, you know, man. And I didn't get out of the bar. I get down driving down the road, 4 o'clock in the morning, and I'm driving past this hospital, and here's this old man right out in the middle of the road, man. And I mean, I'm like, whoa, you know, I damn near hit the guy, you know, out there in the middle of the road. And it's like, what did he do? Escape from the hospital, you know? And the man's got an IV coming out of his arm, you know? So, man, I call 911, you know? And you know how 911, they are attentive to your needs. Very attentive. And, well, they answer the phone. And instead of saying 911, you can hear a group of people in the background laughing their asses off, just laughing. I'm like, freaking out, is this 911? And they're like, yeah, we see you in front of the hospital. You know how they got these cameras today, and they're like, you know, you almost hit Harry, oh my God, it's Harry. Harry, you're so scary. Harry, you know, it's like, oh my God. I'm like, man, he's got his IV out of his arm, you know. They send out the police, and you know how the police are, you know.
You know how the police are.
Protect and serve. Yeah, right. Biggest joke there, man, you know. And then, you know, they got to drill me. Drill him, you know.
Dan Songer with his social commentary.
And the dents, you know. Don't be running over Harry. And I'm like, oh no, it's Dick. He's trying to give it to me again. Oh no, man. The dude's got an IV in his arm. You know? Hey, man, you know, I had a good friend of mine gave me a gift card. Very, very nice gesture, because I was like running out of gas, man, running out of gas, kind of like I am here, you know. But anyway, he gives me a gas card from the Shell gas station, and so I mean, it was like $25 gift card, very nice to help me and get me some gas. And I go up to the gas station, and I put some money in my bike, came out to be like $8.25, you know, and put it in my motorcycle, and I went in there and gave the girl the card. And real cute girl, real cute clerk, really pretty, a pretty lady. And so I'm like, you know, mathematics, I'm sitting here trying to figure out how much is left, you know, on the card. And I'm like, $16.75, you know. And this girl, real sharp, she's like, yeah, you're right. And I'm like, well, you know, I used to be a mathematician, you know. And she's like, yeah, you know. And I'm like, well, what's the square root of 25? And man, she snapped back, 5, you know. And I'm like, yeah, you know, if you don't use it, you lose it, you know. And she's like, well, I was gonna say something to you, Dan. And I'm like, what do you think I've been hitting on you all these times, baby? If you don't use it, you lose it. So use it until you're satisfied, whatever it is. You know, if you don't use it, you lose it. So use it. Use it. Use it till you're satisfied, baby. Come on. Whatever it is, you got to use it. Use it. Use it. Daniel Songer. Thank you.
And finally, we hit... Well, not finally, but...
Ladies and gentlemen,
we've gone through 100 of these.
Comedian, entertainer, Daniel Songer.
Got some mail.
Hey, Daniel Songer, I am back. Now, guys, this is Comedy Act 100. Comedy Act 100, and this is the comedy act that I'm going to do greatest hits and the most views. Hey guys, you notice from my previous comedy acts that I have been fading away, my friends. I am fading away. And as you know from history, that all of the greatest poets had to fade away before they became recognized. So I am fading away, my friends, fading away. Comedy Act 100. Probably the final episode, because I am fading away, my friends. So anyway, this is the greatest hits, and I want you guys, danpoetman.com leads to my publisher, authorhouse.com, and if you are a reader out there, please check out my books, because they are all short stories, all in poetry, all to give peace and joy. And my dream is to bring harmony to this world. So go onto my sites and purchase my books for the great joy, because that's what I'm doing, my friends. I am fading away so I can become recognized. So here it goes, my last comedy act. Hey, I was out in my backyard drilling, and I struck oil. It was a gusher. I found out later that the gas station next door lost all their oil. Oh my God, you know? Hey, road trip. Anybody been out there on a road trip? Well, my buddies, they called me up and said, Dan, we're heading to Cocoa Beach, man. And I jumped in the car. Road trip, man. I get to Cocoa Beach and my buddy, he buys a case of beer. And I'm like, well, that kind of leaves me out. What am I going to buy? And I ended up getting a gallon of Jack Daniels, and we went out of the beach partying. And they got bands strung out down the whole beach. And so I started going down to each band, pouring shots out for all these honeys, man, pouring shots for all these gorgeous girls, man. And well, I got down to the beach several miles, I should say, and it came time to relieve myself, man. I go out in the ocean and I'm peeing, and man, all of a sudden, man, this band starts playing a kick-ass song, man. It just really draws you in. So, man, I had to turn around, and I'm watching the band, and all the band and all the people watching the band, they all turn and start watching me, and I'm like, what's up with this, you know? Well, I quickly realized the water was at my knees. I'm like, I'm peeing here, man. I'm peeing, you know? And hey, guys, you ever watch that movie, The Hulk? The Hulk, man. You ever watch that movie? Well, I was in the United States Army, honorably discharged veteran, and I got a name in there as being The Hulk. And I was over in Germany, and I was in these barracks, man, where it was like I had to share it with 10 guys, you know, 10 guys in these barracks, you know, and we're all drinking that German beer, man, getting hammered, you know, and a sergeant comes in, and he wants to partake with the party, man, party animals, you know, and well, we're partying, he yells out, everybody jump on Songer, you know, all of a sudden I got 10 guys on my back, sergeant, he comes running, soars through the air, bam, right on the pile, man, and all of a sudden he starts yelling, everybody get off of him, it's the Hulk, get off of him, man. And everybody just got off of me, man. I stand up. I'm like, I'm hot, man. And he's like, man, you're the Hulk. He said, I got blown off 10 feet. The guy below me got blown off. No, I didn't blow anybody off. No. And he's like, like, man, the next guy got blown off, the next guy got blown off. And I'm like, no, I didn't blow anybody off. But man, I was like doing a push-up, man. I was pushing them guys, push, push, push. You know, I was pushing them, man. And I was blowing them all off, man. Blowing them all, you know. Hey guys, I don't know if you tried internet dating, but it has been totally crazy, crazy for me, internet dating. I mean, every woman that is on the internet turns out to be a man. I mean, you know, they create these pictures that they're, I come across this profile, guys, and it was the most beautiful woman you would ever see in your life. You could comb the whole entire planet and never find this girl. That's how beautiful she is. And she's got on there, I'm looking for a man that's tall, dark, and handsome. And man, so man, what am I gonna do? I send her a message, well, I'm short, white, and fat. And she sends back a message, you are so beautiful to me. Can't you see that I love the fat boy? I need the fat boy. I want the fat boy. You know, I'm like, whoa.
Sorry, Elaine.
Whoa, you know?
It's the weekend.
Well, I get together, and it turns out, she's tall, dark, and handsome.
We're at 100.
Oh, man. Hey, guys, you know what? Names out there. If you put your name on the internet, you would not believe how many names out there is the same name as you. Same name, you know? And out of curiosity, I'm like, Daniel Songer. And you wouldn't believe how many Daniel Songers there are around this world. And I'm like, oh, my God, you know? I thought I was the only one, you know? Daniel Songer, you know, the one and only, you know, and I'm like, look what they've done to my name, man. Look what they've done to my name. They've taken it down to a low down, nasty shame, man. Look what they've done to my name. Now who is to blame, man? Look what they've done to my name. Now I'm taking my name to fame, man. Daniel Songer, Dan Poet, man. I'm taking it to fame, man. Look what I've done to my name. Hey guys, you know what? Movies out there. Movies, when I watch movies, I use a method like baseball. Strike one, strike two, strike three, and you're out. And I was watching this movie, and with that method and that grading system, I mean, right from the beginning, it was strike one, strike two, strike three. I was drawn into it, and it was like it started to grow on me with these strikes, you know? And I'm strike four, strike five, and it kind of goes hand in hand with my comedy act. And I'm telling you guys, my friend, it was like strike one, strike two, strike three, strike 100, and I'm out. Dan Poet, man, look what they've done to my name, man. Daniel Songer, Dan Poet, man, thank you.
All right. Thing doesn't want to work anymore. Where's 101? I'm gonna have to take a break after a few of these. I'm starting to get Songer fatigue.
Ladies and gentlemen, comedian Daniel Songer.
Hey, Daniel Songer, comedian, entertainer, comedy act 101.
Huh? Wait a minute.
And for the numbers people out there, that's 101, comedy act 101. Hey, you guys, you know, There has been this great thing all over the world is called an accent. Accents all over the world, and man, it becomes earth-shattering, you know? You become so mesmerized by some of these accents. And my accent has always been a cross between a straight man and you would probably say a homosexual, you know? And especially if I get really excited, my vocal cords go up several octaves.
Too bad.
You know?
My tolerance is higher.
Oh my God, you know? It's like they're making their observation.
It's all those songs.
He is gay, you know? It's like their observation. You know, and I think the greatest man on the planet Earth is a man that is masculine and feminine at the same time. You know, masculine and feminine at the same time, you know. Man, it sounds like a lesbian's wet dream. We've got the accent. We got it going on. We've got the masculinity and the feminine action going on. You know, it's got, you got to be masculine and feminine at the same time, you know. It's
like, I always have plenty of scorch.
Hey, being feminine might get you where you want to be, you know. Make the observation, you know. I mean, it's the accents out there. They're so mesmerizing, and you know, my accent, it might throw you off, but I'm really a man. I'm masculine, feminine, at the same time, you know. Hey, you know, what every woman's encouragement is that this saying, it was like made up a long time ago, but it's a great encouragement for women. It's like, we must increase our bust, you know? It was like the greatest encouragement for women, you know? And the only problem is that the men today, they're getting these implants put in, you know? And they believe in the, we must increase our bust, you know? It's like, oh my God, guys, you know? And the women today, they come in here from all over the world, you know, hoping to get a green card. And what they have in common is with the women who want to conceive a baby. It's like, you must insert your bust. You must insert your bust. You must insert your bust, you know? It's like, man, you know, it's like, oh, where is this going to, guys? It's like, you know, listen, ladies, don't get the insertions done. You look very beautiful naturally, you know, and it's meant to happen, you know, where if you got small
I'm
ones,
just trying
you know,
to control your bodies,
you
man.
Ones, you know, it don't matter. It's all natural. You're beautiful. And I tell you, you keep it going. We must increase our bust. Yeah, you know, so it is a must to get out there and increase your bust, increase the must, increase the satisfaction. Yeah, hey, you know, guys, I have been doing internet dating for quite a long time. I've shared all my stories with you, but I want to tell you that when I first started on the internet dating, I heard of MySpace, you know, so created a profile there, and my friends, I was like, oh my God, I mean, everyone loves me. They're like, everybody wants to be my friend. Everybody wants to be my baby. Everybody wants to be my friend. Boy, man, was I deceived, you know? It was like a popularity contest. Everybody wants to be my friend, but they really don't know what the true meaning of friends are. They were not my friends. They just wanted somebody to be on their list. Oh, I've got 3,000 friends. Yeah, baby, we're interested in one thing, though, you know. So, man, I was glad to learn about Facebook, created my site on there, and along came all the friend requests, and I was like, wow, man, these guys, they might actually be my friends. I got messages like, Dan, we love your comedy act.
And I didn't think it would take this long.
It was cool. It was cool. You know, and I try to give that all to you. And I'm like, oh, wow, you know, this might be it. This might be it for me, you know. And I've got on there, you know, hey, I am single, you know. And I'm like, man, you know, I decide I change that to it's complicated, you know. And I'm like thinking to myself, what a wonderful world. You know, I was thinking to myself that, man, these people might think I'm a homosexual. I mean, what does a homosexual say? I'm single? You can't say you're married, man. No, you can't say that, can you? It's like, it's complicated, man. You know, and I'm thinking, oh boy, I decide I gotta change that. Change it real quick, you know, put it back to single, single. You know, but I got a statement with that single. Love me tender. Love me true. All your dreams fulfilled. Love me, baby. All your dreams come true for you. And I will always love you. Love me. Love me. Love me. Love me, love me tender, love me true, all your dreams fulfilled. Daniel Songer.
Right. Let's take a break from Dan and put this on. See if I can. I pop this out or something. Ah, that's how it works.
Not so fast, space clown. My time-space manipulator has assembled an army of invisible cavemen to block your reverse polarity ray.
That's a neat trick, future fool. But my frequency demodulator rerouted your cave creeps to the Victorian era, where they will be mocked for their ill manners and crude mode of dress.
That's unlucky. I suspect my future's not so bright after all.
Yep.
That's all well and good, space dud. But I've saved the best for last. Take this.
It seems to be some kind of gas.
It is the ancient favor of Kintave, space goon. You will now be driven to feed off the flesh of humanoids to survive.
Seriously?
This is the Ghost Planet channel on Adult Swim's website.
My guest tonight
is just all
the
like
symbol of man
this weird repackaged
a mysterious
stream
and complex
that
universe,
they do.
Moby
and Richard Crenna, right?
No, I put him in my mouth and ate him.
Really?
I'm kidding. Richard had to go. He had
an appointment.
You know Richard.
No, I don't know Richard.
Oh, go grapple with your lever.
Zorak, please play me to the desk, if you please. Oh, excuse me.
Hi.
Biscuit.
Not now.
Biscuit.
What do you want?
Well, my name's Moby, and I'm from New York City. Where are you from?
I'm from outer space, Moby, home of the universe.
Biscuit.
Are there any trouble spots in the universe right now that you can talk about?
Yes.
Biscuit.
Sorry.
What did you think about the Shoemaker-Levy comet that crashed into Jupiter?
Shoemaker what?
The Shoemaker-Levy. It was a three-stage comet that crashed into Jupiter.
Wow.
Yeah, and they said that if a comet like that hit...
Was that on a Tuesday? Because I think I had a guitar lesson that day.
Yeah, but you would think something like that. That's like being a policeman.
Listen, I can't worry about every little snafu. I have celebrities to talk to, like Moby.
Celebrities, huh? So celebrities are more important than the safety and well-being.
Nobody cares, Moby. Nobody cares. No one.
Are you sort of new to this interview process?
I've been doing it for thousands of years, Moby.
Well, you can't tell.
Oh, well, thank you for the compliment.
It wasn't intended as one.
Well, sometimes those are the best compliments of all. I'll tell you, Moby, it sure hasn't felt like thousands of years. But I guess that's because on my planet, it's still only Tuesday, my guitar lesson!
Oops.
Hey, Biscuit. Biscuit.
Not now.
Stuff you.
Stuff you too. Zorak's a villain, Moby.
And what about this lava character? Another villain.
So if you're such a nice, benign,
feed off the flesh of humanoids to survive.
A character, how come you surround yourself with so many miscreants?
This guy's got a nice bony head.
I reckon.
I bet that bucket's got some treats inside.
Are you a vegetarian?
Not really.
Moltar, send out another tender celebrity for me to interview.
You ate Moby.
No, I didn't.
You sure about that?
Am I sure? Moltar, I think I'd know if I ate a guest, okay?
Call from?
This is Jagar from San Diego. I'd really like to know what to do my sister for her birthday.
That's the worst question you can Well, I found out what women want. It took me 52 years to know what they want. And the answer is everything. So whatever you give her, she'll appreciate. Give them food that'll last for at least a month. And that way she'll never forget you or forgive you. And that, the reason women like to get flowers is God, they wasted a lot of money on me, but they were thinking about me. They're smarter, they're stronger, and they don't play fair.
Yeah, I've put up with that all my life.
Yep. It's surrender. We have no egos left, just surrender.
Yeah, no. Two sisters and a mom, I'm kind of... I've been putting up with it.
Okay. We're out of time.
Okay.
And we're clear.
Well, that wasn't very good.
I'm sorry.
Oh, no, it's all right, really. You're just not very good.
No. I'm loving. Cuddly.
You really mailed that one in.
Hi.
Are there usually questions and answers, or am I just wrong about that?
Yeah, I just keep thinking about last week's show. It had everything. Action, girls, kung fu sex.
Eruptions from your mouth.
Shut up, Mantis. I'll spin your head off so fast it'll travel back in time. To a period when bugs wore suits and opened doors while saying thank you. And yes, please.
I have no response to that.
It's like working with children, Jerry.
Yeah.
Green ones.
Well, Are we surprised?
Now, listen up as I tell the tale of 15 sexy Kung Fu minutes. Kung Fu, Kung Fu.
Did you create the show?
By create, you mean write, produce, direct, and star in?
Yeah.
Then yes, I created it for you. For Christmas.
In my wildest fantasies, I never imagined that I would really be invited to be on your show.
Wild fantasies.
You have a, I don't know, something about you.
Would you like to have some of my sex with me?
Oh boy, would I.
Let's go.
All right, this is a complete lie.
Shut up, Zorak. It isn't.
She never would.
We'll check the tape. We'll check it right after the show, buddy.
Show's over, genius.
I wasn't told that this was... Is this
and a... That's genius with a J.
This is an ambush show.
Your life's about over.
Yeah, whatever.
It's about over unless you shut up.
I don't want to be a guest on a talk
all
show.
All right, but...
Say it. Say it again, monster.
I never wanted to be on.
Say what you just said.
Yeah, say it.
Say it.
Whoa.
Whoa is what America's going to be saying when I spin his head off so fast it'll travel back in time.
Blah, 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 blah.
Oh, you want the time travel spinning head? Huh? Mister? I'll... Time?
What does that mean?
He doesn't know.
It means there was a time when bugs were obedient to man. This clearly isn't that time.
Nope.
Now, where was I, Jerry?
I don't know. We were kind of...
Ah, yes. The sex.
Of course.
As I moved in to enjoy the sex, terror rained down from the sky.
Oh, my God.
Are there any bones sticking out?
I can't tell. You're hidden by a desk.
I was pinned to the earth.
By a freaking ceiling tile.
Don't! This was no ordinary ceiling tile, Jerry.
Okay.
This was the ceiling tile.
So goes we meet again.
Ceiling!
That's right, I'm back.
The pleasure is mine.
No, correction. The pleasure is all for me. Sprinkler!
No.
Ho-ho!
Tap water.
Oh, now I will freeze you at 60 degrees. Cool air vent. Go!
Ah.
Go! Get him.
He's lowering the temperature of my body.
Oh.
It's all right, contact facilities.
You? Ah. Deal with it!
Son of a... Time to hang, tile.
Asbestos powder! Ah. Get up and face the powder!
No!
Suck it in, ghost, and prepare to die.
Not while I'm alive. Medical school!
Hey! Stop!
Space Ghost has mastered the five magics.
They cause drowsiness.
No!
From your coffin!
You don't have to throw
because
that!
Because you're dead!
Wait! That hurts, no!
Well, it looks like C-Ling will fit in perfectly on the roof in jail.
He sure will, Space Ghost.
Moltar, that's one tile that needs to be replaced.
It sure does, Space Ghost.
Shut up, Zorak. You make me sick.
I do, don't I?
Now, don't we have some sex to take care of?
Yes.
That's how I defeated C-Ling and then, of course, did sex. It was all action, Jerry. Magic and action.
Unbelievable.
And yet very true. And yet very true.
You're insane. You never even took your clothes off.
Of course I didn't. It was sex.
That's some kind of sex.
Moltar, I will spin your head so fast it'll collect its own atmosphere with gravity.
What?
And you'll be dead.
Why?
Because you weren't alive back then.
Well, that ain't how I remember it at all.
What was that? Oh, the lying machine just turned on.
Tell me your story.
First off, I was looking real good.
Oh, here we go.
Anyway, Space Ghost was droning on and on about how he packs for trips.
Underwear. And I always bring one entire knapsack full of soap.
And you are?
Space Ghost.
Right. Is your full name Space Ghost Coast to Coast, or is it just Space Ghost?
Well, I don't know. Hey, want to see how high I can jump? I can jump high. I can go real high.
No. I thought maybe you were joking.
Okay, here goes. Whee! Whee!
Yippee! That went on for ever. Yeah. Luckily, Boston came by and picked me up.
Oh, bull.
They said they needed a keyboardist, and I said, I'm your man, Tiff.
Oh.
So long, suckers! Hell, we win.
That's a lie.
They had this really cool ship. It was this whole freaking city on a flying UFO guitar, powered by rock and roll.
But yeah, like this was on for
Boston rocks.
And where did your friends
like
Boston
7-8 years?
They were on their way to populate a new world where everyone would just rock forever.
That's a lie.
There was not a life form we didn't rock. Is everybody ready to rock? Yeah! Play some guitar! Kick it! Man and Mantis rocking side by side. We're gonna rock your face! Ow! Who's ready to rock and roll? Me and Boston. Just like
thing.
That. We rocked everyone we met. Beautiful. And when they were all rocked out, they dropped me off at home. Thanks, Boston! That rock! Hey, Boston! Keep on rocking! Those guys know how to rock.
Like G.I. Joe, with his pants blown off in the war! Ah, incoming!
Oh,
see that? I touched the ceiling!
And that's when he started crying for Mama.
Mama!
I wasn't saying mama, I was saying trauma, like the kind I was about to dish out. I was announcing it, beforehand.
To your mama.
Besides, if I cried, it was because of kung fu lasers and starvation.
Why don't you explain that?
Yeah, explain it.
If this is all a damned lie! Don't listen to him, Jerry. I'll blow your brains clear into that riverbank, Zorak.
Yeah, sure you will.
But you were friends. Why would you do that?
Why are you always trying to get ahead of me, Mantis?
You're all lying.
Oh, Moltar.
That's right, Jerry. Moltar.
First of all, I had the beautiful rock hair. Space Ghost was in the thing. Talking to someone.
Oh no.
I had everything under control, as usual, when all of a sudden.
Psst. Hey, buddy.
Who said that?
Me.
Where's the driver?
I'm a talking car.
Why are you here?
Why is anyone here?
Whoa. And that.
I'm surprised they licensed that song.
I just need to spend a lot more time at church.
A talking car. Really?
No, you know what? I told it wrong. I had broken my lungs. That's what it was. And I was in the process of gluing them back together. So, there I am. And I start hearing this scary piano music. So I turn around, and there's this guy standing there. And he's wearing this mask. And I'm like, what's up with that? And he's got this knife, and he just starts coming at me, and the knife's like going...
You mean, Michael Myers?
Oh, you know him? Because he was coming right at me.
Yeah, he's in this movie. Halloween? The one I loaned to you a year ago. My movie, remember?
Okay, alright, okay. So maybe it was a movie. I guess I was watching it with some of my friends. I don't know if you know him. They're the rock band Boston?
I don't know.
He doesn't know him. Look at his face. He's lying.
I'm not lying.
Oh, gosh.
Truth is relative, Zorak.
Especially when you're lying.
The trueness of one's truth, Zorak, is clearly based on their vernacular inaccuracies.
What?
Yes, Zorak. Everyone knows that to be true. And you are dumb for not knowing that.
What?
I have to be going soon.
As Moltar clearly said, the vascular...
Say it.
You know, if you couldn't understand the first time, I shouldn't have to waste my mouth saying it again.
It's not like I have another job.
Saying what again?
Yeah, what are you saying?
What I'm saying...
That's not what I said.
What I'm saying...
What
I'm saying is saying things are not relative.
This can't be during a sweeps.
And that, my friends, is the only truth.
Is there an end to any of this?
The other truth is that I totally did sex with that girl.
Okay.
Because I did.
Good.
I completely, totally did.
Yes.
Yes, I think you can say the two of us did that activity.
Oh, and Zorak?
There was a performance.
I totally hung out with Bob.
At the theater, if you catch my drift.
Hey, thanks, guys.
Heh.
thinking, Citizen Hulkster? Are you getting enough O2?
Oh, so this now. I think I'll go to Japan.
Hulk, are you with us?
Yeah, me and that little bee.
Uh-huh.
I know what it is.
Damn, this is an old one.
Okay.
Well, the belt's there because I didn't want any of those space aliens to steal it.
Moltar, I don't think the Hulkster is getting enough oxygen.
Where are we, page 6?
Space ghosts.
Hang on, Hulkster, we're working on it.
5 miles of Cuban waters. Mark.
Moltar, hurry.
Now, what's the inflection on this exactly?
How are we doing, Hulkster?
Does anybody really care what time
Moltar,
it is?
Moltar.
All right, hang on, that wasn't it.
Space ghost, the man with the beef.
That's the big fella. Don't tell me it's okay when it's not okay.
Wait.
Oh, beautiful, beautiful.
There.
How are we doing, Hulkster?
I know now that I'm on Space Ghost's new show.
Alrighty. Hulk, you have an identifying theme that is cloaked in clandestine mystery. Care to divulge it?
Well...
What you gonna do when Hulk Hogan comes to wrestle you?
Come on, what's your secret identity?
My true identity is the leader of the pack.
Inagata da vida, baby.
Yeah.
Oh, don't you know that I'll always be true? Yeah. Inagata da vida, Zorak. You know, Hulky, in some ways, you and Zorak are a lot alike.
No, he's got different colored skin. I'm tan. I'm from California.
Melrose Place. My sister watches that show.
Uh-huh.
And I'm the WCW Heavyweight Champion. That other guy's just a cartoon character.
Hey! What do you mean, just a cartoon character?
Yeah, what's that supposed to mean?
Look, I paid my dues. I waited tables. I answered phones.
I polished silver for the queen.
I made coffee.
Nice lady.
I danced till dawn at Studio 54.
Wow.
Me and Rubel. Man, we could really... Hey, what do you think of Lassie, Hulk?
Well, I'm an animal lover. I don't think I'd want to...
No, I wouldn't either.
Russell Lassie. I wish Lassie was my pet.
Me too. But Ted Turner won't let us have pets in the studio ever since Banjo. Banjo!
Ted Turner? Who's that?
Ted owns us, Zorak. He can push us around. Even you, Hulk.
Well, I don't know.
What if Ted made you do Xeroxing all day in an apron? Would you pile drive him? You would, wouldn't you? Because you're a tough guy. You're Mr. Tough.
He's got pretty big arms the last time I saw him because he's been working out with his wife, Jane Fonda.
I'm Fonda Fonda.
And she's a fitness expert.
Yes, I'm Fonda Bridget Fonda.
Be quiet, brown nose.
Hey, I don't have a nose.
Who's the most powerful man in the Turner organization?
Fonda.
Hulk Hogan or Ted Turner?
I would say Ted. Ted. Then Space Ghost. And then the Hulkster.
I'd love to see if I could body slam that big dude.
Yep, I hear that. Whoa, Daddy. Back at ya. Hey, Babarone.
Hola, amigos. Felicitaciones a México y especialmente a mi amigos de Guaymas. Hola.
Hola, amigos.
Hola.
Hola, amigos. Originally, they used to say, couples skate next, two girls may not skate together. And then, like, a couple years later, they'd say, couples skate, two girls may not skate together, two boys may not skate together. But they'd say it like, who'd have figured, two boys may not skate together. Are we rolling?
How do you do? How do you do, ladies and gentlemen? We're home. Later in the program, we'll be talking to a nice gentleman named Slash. Ow! Ow! I've thrown my back out! Workers' comp! Ah! How'd you going? Hey, Hulk, do you know Slash's last name?
That's his whole name.
Dundee didn't have a last name either. Neither did Henry.
He didn't even have a mouth.
There's Shusha. Hmm?
That's right, Zorak. There's Shusha.
What about her, huh? A word that has no S's, that's full of them. Shusha. 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 Oh, Shusha. Shusha.
Will you come over and put the sleeper on, Zorak?
I don't think any of us, anybody like you, or any of the little Space Ghost kids out there, all those fans of yours, should ever try any wrestling holds at home.
You should never put the sleeper on your boys and your little girlfriends and...
Okay, Hulk, whatever.
Well, it's like you've been eating those space cheeseburgers. I'm looking at your waist and that belly is hanging out. So I don't even think you have any laces when you tie your space tennis boots.
My laces are Velcro. So, tell us, what's new in the incredible world of Hulk?
A brand new TV series called Thunder in Paradise, where I get to play an action-adventure hero on TV every week.
An action-adventure hero? Ooh, why didn't I think of that? And you fight crime, right? That's original. Hey, do you beat up any bad guys? Maybe come to the rescue of a few distressed citizens? Sure, maybe even save the day while you're at it.
Well, you know, dude.
Been there, done that, see ya. Voltar, give him a copy of the home game. Please welcome my next guest, Slash.
Yeah?
Okay.
What's happening?
Well, I'm Space Ghost. I'm the host. You just answer my questions.
Then you probably asked me a question I couldn't answer. I feel like a real idiot.
No, no, no. Don't you worry your pretty little head about anything.
Okay.
Are you ready?
I think so.
Okay. Citizen Slash, welcome to the show. You're from Earth, right?
Yeah.
How many clouds does Earth have? You know, son, if you were a paramedic, people would be dead already.
Next question.
Citizen Longhair, when you're on tour, do you ever miss your mommy?
I can't hear you.
Are you even listening to me?
Yeah.
Hello?
I'm here. I just said yeah.
Whatever. Mm-hmm. Whatever, son.
Stupid answer to a stupid...
What?
Never mind.
Where are your eyes?
I can't do this, you guys. I knew this before we got here.
Wait. I saw one.
Get me out of here.
Sing us a zippy guitar riff with your mouth.
No, no. Just listen to the record. I have no intentions of doing any zippy guitar riffs with my mouth.
Here, like this.
No, like this.
No, this.
I'm not going to cooperate with you. I don't have to.
Oh, really?
Uh-uh.
You know what, Slash? We'll be right back.
Cool.
Yeah, Slash.
I think you need to get your own car. I can't pick you up every single day. Maybe you could get a bike.
Just drive. Not in the mood.
If you think I'm going to keep picking you up like this every day, you're sorely mistaken, little mister. Moltar and I don't work 15 minutes a week to have you treat us like your servants. So you had just better start saving up your money, Buster Brown, because this is the last week I'm putting wear and tear on this cruiser when you can't even show a little appreciation for how hard we work. In fact, you know what I think? I think maybe you need to get out there and find yourself a part-time job. Don't you have any skills? What do you like to do?
Nothing.
Hmm. Well, what are you good at?
Everything.
I'll ask my friend Merle if he needs any help.
Who's Merle?
You know, Merle. At the lumberyard.
I ain't working at no lumberyard.
Well, you're not gonna be a freeloader all of your life. What? What did you say to me?
Nothing.
Hey, I'm lost in the woods right now. Where the hell am I?
Turn left. You've got to go left.
Doesn't help, man. It's all just trees here. I don't know. It's night outside right now.
Find a path, and at the end of the path, there'll be a key. There'll be a it's a path within 100 feet of you, and at the end of that path there's a key, and it's an old key, and it's a skeleton key, and inside that skeleton key is a pouch, and it'll have all the maps to tell you how to get out.
Oh, awesome.
Yeah,
right.
Yeah. I think it. Cool. Go to your left 100 feet.
Okay, I'll just turn left.
Turn, always turn left. Yeah.
Okay, all right. So it's like NASCAR.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah.
When in doubt, cool. Go out or do something familiar. Have you ever died for your county?
It's Mark Hamill here.
Whoa! Look who's here, young people. It's none other than Duke Fartknocker.
Luke Skywalker.
Luke Skytopper of the popular Space Wars science fiction mega empire franchise.
I think it's much more along the lines of a fairy tale than it is straightforward science fiction.
Whatever, Professor. How's Chewie?
Chewie? Well, you know,
You and me both. But seriously, Mark, was it scary working with Lord Vader?
James Earl Jones is just such a gifted person and...
Prowse.
Huh?
David Prowse. He played Vader in the movie version, not Jones.
Maybe I said a dirty word.
Oh, you did, pal.
David Prowse. Are you joking? If this is a joke, I'm not laughing.
Prowse is the true Lord Vader.
Prowse? He was a figurehead. It is Jones who is the true Vader.
Answer me this, Moltar. Who patrolled the galleys of the Death Star?
The Ewoks.
Don't patronize me, Bantha Fodder.
Well, if you consulted your handbook, you would know it was the Stormtroopers.
Yes, of course, but who led them, Moltar? Huh? Who led them? Refresh my memory on this one, if you please. Would that be...
Prowse, but
exactly!
He, but...
Exactly, Moltar. That's exactly what I thought.
Hey, what do you fellas think of those Ghostbusters? You'd think they'd scare me because I'm, you know, I'm a ghost. I mean, hey, Zorak, who are you gonna call?
I'm gonna call you an idiot.
What?
You heard me, mouth breather.
Trust in your feelings, Tad. Use the power bands.
Wouldn't be interested in a new career as a sidekick, would you?
Well, you know, it beats Ed McMahon.
I must warn you, you would be required to laugh at the outrageously hilarious antics of a talk show in outer space.
Yes. I can do that.
I like your attitude, Hamill. Come in Monday for paperwork.
Yes.
Whoa, save some for the convention, buddy.
Yes.
So what do you do at these conventions? Do you say, show how you ate breakfast on Tatooine? Is it Tatooine?
Oh, me eating cereal would be...
Impressive.
This is just sad.
That's amazing, Mark. Would you bring your imaginary ball of cereal to my convention?
That'd be great. If I'm in your galaxy, I'll stop on by.
Great. Then I'll see you at Space Ghost Con 97.
Thank you so much for having me.
I don't know. He sounded iffy.
That's not the Luke Skytopper I know.
You don't know Luke Skywalker.
Can you ever really know a man, Zorak? I mean, sure, you can know what he does, where he lives, the way his hair smells in the morning after a brief rain. Wait a second! I've got to buy supplies for...
Space Ghost Con 97!
What a selection! You don't have to be a superhero to appreciate these super savings.
This is CNN. Oh, and Luke, I'm your father. Did you get to sign my helmet yet? Son?
Yeah, I signed it.
It was great having you at our sci-fi con, man.
Thanks so much.
You're not really going to Space Ghost Con, are you?
No. I was working, and I have another job after this, actually.
Good.
Greetings! The future of convention excitement awaits you at Space Ghost Con 97.
Use the phone tab.
The phone lines are open to order your tickets to Space Ghost Con 97, featuring me, Space Ghost. Call 1-800-555-SG-97. #839174982, extension 49. Call now. The lines are open and I'm standing by. Lines are open.
All right, I think it's snack time.
Greetings, one and all. I'm Space Ghost.
So what? Go on and start the dumb show.
Actually, we're not doing our regular show tonight, Zorak.
You mean it won't stink?
And so it begins. No, Zorak, I'm saying that I have a special surprise for you tonight. Zorak, here is your life!
What? Moltar, why didn't you warn me?
Nobody tells me anything.
That's right, Zorak. Moltar didn't know a thing about this. You see, I only told two special friends of yours. And then they told two friends. And then they told two friends. And so on. And so on. And so on.
Well, I don't want no stinky. Here is your life. It's embarrassing.
Oh, hush up, Mr. Party Poop Bug. It'll be fun, fun, fun. We're gonna have guests who will talk about you and surprises. And afterwards, we're all going to a party downtown at the Taco King.
The Taco King?
It's where the refried bean reigns supreme.
Alrighty. Zorak, here comes your life.
Can't we skip this garbage and go straight to the tacos?
No, now pipe down. Ah, Zorak, what can one say? Born into a small family, made even smaller by disgusting acts of cannibalism, you quickly entered into young bughood and a life of evil.
Hail, evil!
May I continue?
Sure, it's your show.
Now, Zorak, tell me if you remember this voice from your criminal past. Oh, well, do you remember this voice?
Hi, Zorak, my name is Brack.
Sorry, doesn't ring a bell.
This one?
Hey, Zorak, you evil locust.
Nope.
Ah, work with me here. Now, do you know this voice?
Hey there, Zorak. Remember that cavity search warden Smith put us through that one wacky New Year's?
I give up.
You're not even trying, are you?
Shh, don't give him any hints.
I don't know. Steve?
No, no, no! Lord, man, don't you know your own life?
It's your old cellmate from Prison Planet Alpha DD7, master villain, and would-be world conqueror, Cyclo.
Hey, Zorak.
Hey, Cyclo. So, what you been doing?
Oh, the usual, tend to life.
Sorry.
Well, see ya, Zorak.
Yeah. So long, Cyclo.
So, Cyclo, will you be joining us at the Taco Master after the show?
I can't, stupid. I'm in jail.
Oh, yeah, right.
Being here tonight reminds me of how much I miss prison.
Isn't this here is your life stuff great, Zorak?
If we're really gonna do this, I gotta go change vests.
Okay, here's our first special guest to tell us all about Zorak and his ilk. Greetings, citizen. Welcome to Zorak's Life.
Hi there.
Identify yourself to the universe, please.
I'm Maxie Nolan, professor of entomology at the University of Georgia.
That means bug guy, right?
Yes.
Great. We've brought you here tonight to talk to us about our little friend,
the great Zorak.
Look, friend, I know Zorak, okay? And he's not that great. Got that?
Yes.
Good. As I was saying, this is our mantis of the quarter hour, Zorak.
Hi, Zorak.
Kiss my...
Pretty scary, huh? Huh?
Yes, yes.
Freaky, in fact.
6 feet in size, and a praying mantis at that.
And evil to boot.
Eh.
Now, technically, is Zorak an insect or a pest?
What is your definition of a pest?
I don't know. I asked you.
A plant out of place is called what?
A transplant?
A weed.
I knew that.
An insect that's out of place and doing bad things is called...
A weed.
A pest.
Exactly.
What category should we place Zorak in today?
I think that's very clear.
Pest.
Yep, he's a pesty insect pest. But shouldn't he have 6 legs?
Well, they're supposed to have 6 legs. How many legs does Zorak have?
2 legs, 2 arms, kind of got a beak.
Is it possible that under that red vest, he is carrying an extra set of arms that no one has found out about yet?
Ugh, barf!
Actually, that's where I keep my Mentos. Das Freshmaker.
Have you ever dipped a mantis into rich, creamy milk chocolate?
I've taken mantis and I have dipped them in alcohol and made him drunk.
Woohoo! Sign me up! Hello, sailor.
Why do you like these evil green things anyway?
One thing that I find just most absolutely amazing about the mantises is the fact that they can stand motionless for hours, literally not moving any body part that is visible.
Actually, nobody moves much in a Hanna-Barbera cartoon.
That's very interesting.
Not really. Well, thanks for being with us, Mr. Nolan, and telling us all about pests. Will we see you at ye old taco shop after the big show?
Chomp, chomp, chomp.
Huh? I'll take that as a maybe. Okay, folks. Next, we have an old film clip of Zorak to show you.
Ye gods! You're not gonna show that old thing, are ya?
That's right. We're going to see the first time I ever met our evil weevil little bug pal and beat the living daylights out of him. It's called, simply, Zorak. Enjoy.
Moltar!
Okay. Need some nourishment.
Space Ghost is not here, but he left us 2 hostages.
Need to find the...
I can still
never used the motion
revenge.
Tool before.
Zorak!
Come,
Where are we going?
No questions.
It's a trade. Your life for my hostages. Signed, Zorak.
Those stupid kids. Why did I even bother?
What have you done with Jan and Jace, Zorak?
They are right here, Space Ghost. And they are still alive. And they will stay that way if you follow orders. It's your life I want, not the hostages.
Man, Zorak, what was with your voice back then?
Yeah, well, what's up with your voice? Those sounds you hear are my killer musketoids, Space Ghost.
Not the killer mosquitoes. Ooh. Okay, watch what I do here. You thought you had me here, didn't you?
It's Blip with my power bands. Good work, Blip.
Space Ghost has regained his powers. Take them to the flying bomb.
I've got to get them out.
Flying time bomb. Brilliant.
Boy, are we glad to see you.
No time to talk. Take these emergency rocket packs and eject fast. I'll head this ship back to Zorak with our best wishes. There, Zorak. Let's see if you can take it as well as you can dish it out.
Now, do we need to watch this part?
Oh, hold on. This is so good.
Did you see that? Where I blew up his planet? Oh, man!
I would have defeated you if it wasn't for those meddling kids. And that monkey.
Well, I mean, putting jetpacks in the rocket, that's not too sweet.
Oh, shut up!
Hey, Moltar, let's see that footage of Zorak's planet blowing up one more time.
I'm sorry, Zorak. I'm not laughing at you. I was. Well, okay. I was laughing at you.
Say, Zorak, just how did you escape certain death when I blew up your planet?
I crouched.
Crouched?
Down low, behind a rock.
Huh.
Matilda?
Yes, this is Matilda.
Hello. So what's up?
Just sitting at my desk. What's up with you?
Just answering a bunch of knuckleheaded callers.
So, how have you been, Zorak?
I've had my moments. So what brings you here? You watch TV and stuff?
Yeah, I love TV.
What's on your TV usually?
Sometimes it's cartoons.
Cartoons? Okay.
Yeah.
All right, we're done here.
Our next guest is an expert in pest control. That means killing insects. Greetings, citizen. Welcome to Zorak's Life.
Thank you for having me.
Identify yourself, please.
Steve Arnold, Peachtree Pest Control.
Bow, bow.
Pest control?
That's right, pest control.
That means you kill insects, right?
Yeah. We try not to use those words if possible.
Why not? Them's good words. Say, Steve, you know, I need help controlling a pest.
I was afraid you were going to bring him up.
Oh, he's my...
I know.
You know who he is?
Know him quite well.
Gonna get ya.
Ooh, is motion
pretty
paths.
Scary, isn't he?
Only when he's looking my way.
When you're
gonna
doing
get
a
ya.
What would you use to control pests like Zorak?
Hammers, bricks, 2x4s.
You go right at it, huh?
So. I go in there with intent to kill, destroy, eliminate.
Sounds good. Do you have anything cool you say right before you whack them?
Take this.
Take this.
That's a layer.
Take this, and this. I like it very much.
It's short, it's simple, and usually works.
Do you mind if I use it? Can I take this?
It's yours.
Thanks. Say, Steve, what else can we learn about Manti?
The Mantis family has a tendency to be cannibalistic of their own kind.
Knew that one already, thanks.
Hmm.
Here's a stumper. Any idea why Mantises wear cheap polyester vests?
To impress the females, I would assume. It used to work in the 60s back here on Earth. It doesn't work nowadays.
Do any other pests wear polyester?
No. Matter of fact, most of them have moved up into the wools and silk blends.
Well, thanks for being with us, Mr. Insect Killer.
Thank you for having me.
Gonna get ya.
Well, Zorak, there you have it. Your miserable little life.
I only have one thing to say. Space Ghost.
Yes?
Here is your death!
Ow! Jerk. That hurt.
It was supposed to.
Oh, I see. Well, take...
This.
Oh, get a load of that one. She's sublime. Those twitchy eyes.